Hi everyone. Today we will talk about tracing on page table in this session. I am YuHsiang Tseng, a Linux daily user. And my co-speaker ChinEn Lin will give a lecture afterward. So in this session, we will first introduce what the page table is and how it works, and then talk about current tracing tools and a framework in Linux kernel like kprop, tracepoint, ftrace, and so on. Next, introduce our tracing implementation, the virtual memory profiling. And finally, we will look on a recent patch on page table. Okay, so each process has its virtual memory area. In Linux kernel, the process control block is represented as text chart, and its memory layout is shown as the image below. The MM chart pointer in text chart indicated the virtual memory area of process, and there is a VM area chart pointer in MM chart describe the memory mapping information. Look at the right image. As we can see, there are PGD and MMAP in MM's chart. The PGD is the top level page table, and the MMAP pointer referred to is its virtual memory area, which can be any section like stack, heap, BSS, or data in the image at the bottom. First, let's look at the image at right side. We can see that each process has its virtual memory area, and the memory management unit (MMU) help LAN transfer the memory from virtual address to physical address. We can regard physical memory as a set of many pages. A single page is called frame, and each of them has the same size. And the page table is used for managing these pages, such as PGD, the top level page table we have mentioned in the previous page. So each page table level contains the beginning of next level page table, just like this image. Since the fast growing memory size and the emergence of 64-bit CPU architecture, page table need more level to access more address space. The full level page table first appeared in Linux kernel 2.6.11 and the kernel version 4.11 RC2 merged the 5 level page table, and both of them are indicative of where the computer industry is going. So how the physical page be found by virtual address in Linux kernel? First, it will call PGD offset function to get a PGD entry and calculate the P4D entry by this P4D offset function. And so on. Finally, it arrives PTE entry and do the same thing to get a physical page. It's a structured page, like calculate the offset. It is noteworthy that for a page with bigger size, it's called huge page. It can be found in PND or PUD. A page table entry in ASP.86 Linux kernel can be represented as below. Even though it is often just unsigned integer, it is defined as chars for two reasons. The first is for type protection, so that they will not be used inappropriately. And the second is for features like PAE on the S86 where an additional 4 bits is used for addressing more than 4 gigabits of memory. The bits shown on left side are S86 Linux kernel defined page table entry protection bits, which describe the properties of current page table entry. For example, if a page table entry with page bit RW and is set on 0, but we try to write on this entry, it will cause a page fault. And when the page fault happens, the function call trace as below. Continue the example at the previous page. If we try to write a page which is not writable in S86 architecture, it first call execute page fault function, and so on. The findVNA function will find out the memory address where the page fault caused, and call doWPage function to handle the page fault error finally. After talking about page table concepts, it's time to talk about tracing tools. The image below shows the mainstream Linux trace tools. The most common tracing tools are kpop and tracepoint, which used for tracing Linux kernel dynamically and statically, respectively. And both ftrace and abbf are based on this. In kernel, there is already exists a dump page table file under architecture S86MM, like a right side. And this file, if you turn on the corresponding config, you will see this file in the left side, like current kernel, current user, EFI in kernel, under the sys kernel debug page table directory. And we can get some page table information through this way, like cat current kernel. And there is some page table information. So this after all is one way of doing it. The function tracer ftrace can be used to find out what is going on inside the kernel. It can be used for debugging or analyzing latencies and performance issues that take place outside of user space. The ftrace framework reads the control information from the trace file system and modifies the kernel dynamically to enable or disable a specific trace event. All the tracer information will be printed in the kernel rim buffer and can be read from trace file system in user space. It is easy to use because it only needs some simple command line tools like cat and echo to communicate with debug file system. So you can use it in some embedded system even if it only has a busy bus. And for convenience usage, it has a command line front-end tools named trace command, which may use ftrace easily and more user-friendly. The ebpf is an internal virtual machine which can be used for tracing kernel event hooks. There are multiple different front-ends for ebpf to generate the bpf bytecode, such as C and perf, BCC, bpf trace, or PLY. After the front-end generates a bpf bytecode, The BPF verifier will check safety of the code and then pass to the eBPF virtual machine and load it into kernel. The user space can use eBPF map or perf event to get the real-time tracing information from the eBPF.
Hi, my name is ChinEn Lin. I'm going to talk about the trace tool that we propose, the virtual memory profiling. The difference between two previous trace tools is that the virtual memory profiling can customize the data you want to store and the prop points you want to insert. It's just like the trace point it's when you are using it. And The major feature we add is that the trace can store the sequential event and immediately interact with the data we record. So we can deal with the information and make the compare to each other to decide what next targets we are interested at. Virtual memory profiling will combine the event with the process by making the pair of the task structure, which is at the pointer of virtual memory events group to the task structure, and we use the filter of the event trace to get the process that we want to trace on. To add the events in our trace tool, we need to define our own data structure with the structure VMP event and with the VMP prefix of the enumerates. Afterward, it needs to also define our own record function and the trace point to report the information to the user space. Each sequential event will store at one of the index of the sequential events. The array of the event VMP event, which is the member of the VMP events group. And the index we specific is using the ticket, which is the atomic type. So we can promise that there's no other events will stored in the same index of the sequential event when we and let's still have the generic event we can use for store the global data and we want to save. Here is a sample. First, we define our own enumerates, the VMP type page table. Then we declare the event, which the name is the PG table, and the sequential event size. Moreover, we define the protocol, the prototype of the record function, and the argument name of the record function. Then we need to define our own data structure with the VMP prefix. So we define the two data structure. The first is to store the generic data. Like we are interested on how many PTE logged and the PMD and the MM variable locked. None of this, we also interested in some function like the pt gets many, which is the function that we will discuss later, and the pt puts many functions, or the gets on this zero functions, or either the free user pt table functions. And for the sequential events, we define the vmp pg table structure, which will store the information for each we call the record function, like the pg table bytes, the paint vm, or the swap, or either the copy and write page. And since we can customize our record function, so we can define our page table worker to work through all the page tables and collect all the data we want to record. So here we have defined all the information that we are interested in, like the PMD or PUD or P4D's information. So, and when we are using the virtual memory profiling, we need to set the enter and record and an exit function to the corresponding place. So here we use the debug FS to control the enter and exit and set the record function to the function that we are interested in. Like, for example, we mentioned earlier that here is a function that we can record the number of records to that. So the function we defined will be like this. The enter function, we will first initialize the data and the events we will store it. And as here, we just first record the information we want as the initialize. And at the exit function, we will record the last event. Then we will report to the user space by the print information, the print kit, or the trace point interface. And we also provide the macro for each VMP event to travel through all the sequential events. And since the record function will be recursive record by the heap itself, so we use the static variables to prevent the multiple time record, the recursive code, so that we can just only record once at a time. And here is the information we can get it. And here is we record the normal kernel, the default kernel that the page table statement will be like. As you can see, we insert our trace tool successfully to the PID 777 PID, and that task name is the test. The sequential event size we defined is 496. So, and for here, we can see that when we do the exit, we can see that the PT log codes a lot, and the PMD mmap and the patch table log also call a lot of time. And here is the trace. Here is the event trace we can see. And here is the information that the event trace we can see. So we just simplifies here that we just record two events in our virtual memory profile, the entry and the exit. You can see that the patch table bytes is smaller than the when the trace tool exists. Here is another case study that is from other developers' patch. This patch is from they discover that the some malloc library will usually allocate the amount of the virtual memory, and that does not do the unmap to loss virtual memory. They will use the M advice to free the physical memory, but that function will not free the patch table memory when they use it. So in that patch series, they add the PT reference count to the structure of the patch table to track how many users of the PT patch table. So, and when the reference count is equal to zero, the PT table will be freed. And here is the information that we trace the patch. As you can see, the last event, the patch table bytes is less than the previously we trace on the normal kernels, the default kernels. It have the benefits that it will free the patch table bytes, but as you can see, the attach of the reference counts of the PT tables is a lot, and it will have some overhead to the atomic operation, which is the type of the reference count. So it have some trade-off when you are using this patch series that free the unused patch table. So here is how we use our trace tools. Thanks.